Hello everyone, praise the Lord. Just want to invite you to devotion today. As we start, I want us to meditate and focus upon the words from the book of Psalms, chapter 55 and verse 22. The Bible says, "Cast your cares on the Lord and He will sustain you. He will never let the righteous be shaken." That's a word for somebody out there who has many cares, who has many concerns, and he's just wondering what to do with all these things. Where do I proceed from here? The Bible tells us to cast our cares on the Lord, and He'll sustain us, and He'll never let us be shaken. So let's put our confidence in these words and be encouraged and find joy and hope in God who is ever faithful.
Oh, I bless you, Lord. I've had many tears and sorrows. I've had questions for tomorrow. There have been times I didn't know right from wrong. But in every situation, God gave blessed consolation, that my trials only come to make me strong. I've been in a lot of places and I've seen so many faces, but there have been times I felt so all alone. But in that lonely hour, in that precious lonely hour, Jesus let me know I was His own. And oh, it was through it all, through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God. Through it all, through it all, I've learned to depend upon His word. So I thank God for the mountains, and I thank Him for the valleys. I thank Him for the storms He's brought me through. 'Cause if I never had a problem, I wouldn't know that He could solve them. I wouldn't know what faith in His word could do. And that's the reason I'm saying, through it all, through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God. Through it all, through it all, I've learned to depend upon His word. Hey. Through it all, through it all, I've learned trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God. Through it all, through it all, I've learned to depend upon His word. Oh, I've learned to depend upon His word every day. I've learned to depend upon His word.
I thank you, Lord, for your word is dependable, your word is truthful, and through it all, we know that we can make it through. In Jesus' name.
Hello, my name is Pastor Joshua from East Assembly KAG Buruburu. We are once again online to meet you through our devotions. We are so grateful for our supporters. We are so grateful for those who have taken time to write a comment, read, and even listen to the messages that we are pasting. We are going to have more and more coming after, And so we ask you to keep praying for East Assembly, keep praying for the board and the chairman of the board, that all will go well. Father, we thank you, and Father, we bless you. We adore you, Lord Jesus, because we know that this moment is a time to preach your word, is a time to court less and less trouble for ourselves. And Heavenly Father, as we look through the devotion, we ask for your help and strength to be able to court less and less trouble for ourselves. We thank you, and it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'm going to read a scripture, and as I read this scripture, I want to encourage you in your day-to-day life, do everything you can to court less and less trouble for yourself. I'm going to read a scripture, and you'll understand what I'm talking about. Bible says in the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verses 19, "Whosoever therefore shall break one of these least commandments and shall teach man so, he shall be called the least in the kingdom of heaven. But whosoever shall and teach them the same shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven, whosoever shall do." And so this particular scripture reminds us of the importance of seeking godly priorities so that we don't get into trouble. And I'm going to give an example of President Trump, who was the president of the United States. Some political analysts say that America is sort of facing a decline. And this is what they say, that Trump offered a mythic sense of greatness to the USA. It's not easy to fully get a grasp of everything he did. However, he was a great president. Anna said this, God says in his word that whoever does the will of God shall not be called small, but shall be called great. And as I look at the word, I'm reminded of many people in the Bible that were called of God. And when they were called of God, they responded. They were either prophets or they were just local peasants that responded to the Lord's call. And they became people that preached the word. And as I look at the voice of God and as I look at how God speaks to us, I ask the question, has God ever spoken to you? Have you ever been at a point where you forgot to apply what God asked you to do? Then that is the kind of scenario that this particular scripture is talking about. It says, if God speaks, then respond. If God speaks, then do all you can for you to follow after God. The Bible says that you'll be called least for not following after the truth. It's derogatory to God when he preaches, of course, through Jesus, his servant, and obviously through earthly means, and people treat it as a non-issue. And so it is important for us as God's people to give ourselves to the Lord, to hear what God says, and to prove God as mighty and strong in our midst. And to also reiterate that while we praise human beings and we say human beings are doing well and that leaders are doing well, how about our God and our response to him? Why don't we respond to him and become those great men that God intended? So I want to bring to us that it's the most sensible thing to do, to follow after Jesus. It's the most sensible thing to do after you've listened to his word, to follow him and to obey what he says. Anna also bring to you that the Messiah had a lot of influence. And his influence was not a normal influence. It was an influence that had preeminence. You and I can preach the word. Jesus also preached the word, but Jesus had a preeminence. He had something unique with him, that he was the Son of God. He was God himself who came into this earth. And so as we are thinking of obeying the Lord, and as you're thinking of obeying Jesus, who had preeminence, who suffered like we did, who went through perspiration, got tired, got hungry, he understands when we have struggles in obeying him. And so I want to encourage you that it's good for each one of us to follow God. Remember the kind of treatment our friends who are doing political rallies are being given. They are being given stately treatment by the police officers, by the vehicles. How much more should we give our God stately treatment by listening to what he is saying? There are crowds after crowds that are listening to these politicians that are going out from one party and another, and I encourage you, listen to your God. Pay attention to God. It is worth it to listen to him. Remember, he says, you who takes time to listen to God, you'll be called great if you do those things. But you who forgets to do those things, you're going to be called least because of forgetting to follow after God. And so I want to encourage us that it is good to listen to God. It is good to follow after his excellence. Remember, God's excellence is far beyond what we see amongst human beings. Human beings are stately. They'll put on nice coats. They'll drive very good cars. And they will put all sorts of ornaments on themselves and clothes. But how about Jesus, who is excellent, who's awesome, who's greater than our minds can fully fathom? I want to encourage us, think about him and follow him and aim for greatness, because greatness is worth it. I would also say that it's good to remember that when God promises something great, he will fulfill it. If we take time to follow him, if we take time to obey him, he's gonna make us great in his own way. And so I want to give a definition of the word great. According to my context here, it says large in intensity or degree, in admiration, mind or distress, authority, or extremely good in quality. In other words, God will do good things to us. And so I want to speak to us from the scripture, Matthew 5:19, which says, whosoever therefore shall break one of these commandments, who wants to lose their morality? Who wants to miss on the path God has given them? Who wants to practice wickedness and an evil eye in the presence of a great God? I want to encourage us that scripture in itself uses the word crap. It says, if you look at its original words and the discussions therein, it uses the word crap. Now, the word crap is like collecting garbage. It's like collecting something here and something there and something out there if we miss out on following after God. Sometimes we say, whatever you fill yourself in with is gonna come out. So if you fill yourself with good things will come out. If you fill yourself with bad things, that same crap is gonna come out. So Anna encourages that it is good to follow the commandments of God. It's like saying, if you follow him, you're acting like a tailor. And you know what those good tailors do? For them to produce that nice suit, for them to produce that nice trouser, they have to do their stitching very well. They have to take time and stitch and do those things well. In case you send to them the coat that they made, they will stitch it up very, very well. And the thought we are putting across is that get stitched up. Get stitched up. Let the good Lord make that inner man inside of yourself stitched up, neat, and done very well. I want to encourage you that as we aim for greatness, the Bible says that it is good for us to offer discipleship. But then this particular scripture criticizes a particular type of discipleship. Number one, a teacher who is in error, and then he teaches other people to be in error. Number two, remember people like David. Now, David in the Bible was adulterous. David in the Bible did so many errors. And if we are to reproduce those errors in people, then that is being a bad teacher. Bible assures us that that kind of a person who consecutively decides that he's going to give himself to teach people how to do error, that kind of a person is called least in the kingdom of God. And so I want to speak to you and remind you that God's word gives you a rating with God. It gives you a standard with God, and that it is important for us to follow after God. Don't lose out on God, and don't lose out on his standards. I'm not very far from finishing, but I want to say this. Whoever is called least in the kingdom of God probably missed out on being renewed by God. Whoever is called least in the kingdom of God is probably someone who sought increase but not from God. Probably he laid a foundation that is unacceptable before God or immoral. And so I want to bring to us that if we are to do and teach, God will make you great. Remember, God is willing to bless you with greatness. Remember, God will find friends for you, people that will uphold you in that greatness that he gives and makes available for you. And so don't give up in being a great man. Don't give up in following after it. You could even be a politician, a person that is saying, what is it that I need to do in order to succeed as a president, or in order to succeed as a member of parliament, or whatever job that I'm going for? I want to encourage you. God says there is a kind of a person that shall be called great in heaven. And I want you to think about normal stay, for instance, around the world. Desert places are not the best place. They are not the most highly rated lands. But if you go to a fertile place where there's rain and there's hills, you're going to get food. Think about the divine plan of God. Think about listening to God. Think about accepting a crown from God. That crown from God is greater than the things that we get in this world. Won't you pray with me? And won't you stand, just commit ourselves to God so that we may indeed see God increase us to greatness. As many as have taken time to listen to God, Father, we thank you. And Father, we bless you. We adore you, Lord God, in heaven, because we know that following your word is worth it, that following your word is not a mistake. And Father, your word reminds us that you will grant us a place of greatness. You will give us a place of standing if we obey your word. Father, I pray for my listeners. May you grant them strength. May you grant them opportunity to see that elevation happening in their lives. Elevate their families. Elevate their campaign strategies. Elevate many, Lord, in heaven that are taking time to say, God, I want to obey you. Bless them, Heavenly Father, and it's in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen and amen. God bless you.
God of Abraham, you're the God of covenant and faithful promises. Time and time again, you have proven you'll do just what you said. Though the storms may come and the wind may blow, I'll remain steadfast, and let my heart learn when you speak of what it will come to pass. Great is your faithfulness to me. Great is your faithfulness to me. From the rising sun to the setting, same I will praise your name. Great is your faithfulness to me. Whoa, whoa. Your faithfulness, it never runs out. It never runs out. Oh, oh, oh. Your faithfulness, it never runs out. It never runs out.
I put my faith in Jesus.
I put my,
anchor to the ground. My hope and firm foundation. He'll never let me down.
I put my faith in Jesus. My anchor to the ground. My hope and firm foundation. He'll never let me down. I put my faith in Jesus. My anchor to the ground. My hope and firm foundation. He'll never let me down.
put my faith in Jesus, my anchor to the ground, my hope and firm foundation. He'll never let me down. Great is your faithfulness to me. Great is your faithfulness to me. From the rising sun to the setting sun, I will praise your name. Great is your faithfulness to me. So faithful. I trust in your promises, Lord. Yeah. Oh, I believe in your word. So God is faithful, God is dependable, and his promises are true. And amen.